Hello everyone. So we are dealing with the class 10th mathematics. Here we will discuss the chapter first, that is real numbers. So real numbers are the numbers which can be represented on the number line. It can be positive, it can be negative. First concept we are discussing here is division algorithm. Now, there is a particular terminology related to division. So, there is dividend, the number which is to be divided, the divisor by which we divide the dividend, the final complete divisible number that is quotient, and the undivided part that is called remainder. All of you are aware about division and division algorithm. But here we will use this algorithm to find some beautiful results in mathematics in number system, and we will also find HCF of two numbers using this particular division lemma and division algorithm. So I am starting with some few examples of divisions. As you can see, there are several divisions on the screen. In all these divisions, you will notice that the divisor is 5. But the remainder is zero, ranging from 0 to 4. So there is a concept behind this, that whenever number is divided by any number, the remainder will be less than the divisor. The remainder can be 0, but it cannot exceed the divisor. Here in all this division, you will notice that this particular division has divisor as 5, but remainder is ranging from 0 to 4. If you notice that 0 to 4, then 0, then again 1 and again 2. So divisor is always greater than the remainder. We can take several examples here. Like if 42 is divided by 30, here you can notice that remainder is 12, which is again less than the divisor. We talk about some other division, like 63 is divided by 27. Again, the remainder is 9. Here the remainder is 9 means, again it is remainder, the less than divisor. There are some more examples on the screen. You can see in all these divisions, you will notice that always the remainder is less than the divisor. So concept here is, remainder can be 0, but it can ranging from 0 to less than remainder, less than divisor. It means divisor se ek number kam tak hi remainder possible. Now, like coming to the next. So here we talked about the division algorithm. We talk about division terminology. Now, lemma. It is a new word for all of you. But lemma is simply a subsidiary or intermediate or a proved statement used to prove another statement. These are simple rules or simple statements which are proved already, and we can use these proved statements to find some other statements or to find some other proving of theorems or to find some other beautiful results. So lemma are some intermediate statements jo hum use karte hain other statements or other theorems ko prove karne ke liye. Just like this division lemma, this division algorithm has a statement that can be used to prove some other results. That's why this is called as lemma. Since it was given by the mathematician, the Greek mathematician Euclid of Alexander. So it is also known as Euclid division lemma. It is just restatement of the division. If you notice that it is just a restatement of the division. Now this restatement means this whole division can be written in one statement. We use this formula as a verification of the division results. Now, what is that formula? This formula is dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. This is the formula we already studied in our previous classes. Here, dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Now, for this particular division algorithm or division lemma, I just want to use two numbers A and B which are positive in nature, and using this A and B as dividend and divisor, I can write a result like A is equal to BQ plus R, where A is the dividend, d is the divisor, q is the quotient, and r is the remainder. And according to our condition, remainder is always less than the divisor. It means remainder condition is written in the screen. Remainder is always greater than 0 or equal to 0, and it should be less than divisor, that is b. So if we write a as dividend, b as divisor, q as quotient, and r as remainder, so the result will be a is equal to bq plus r. That is the statement of that particular lemma. Now lemma is just a simple proved statement, but what do you mean by algorithm? Algorithm is a simple term of English. It means a step by step process to solve any problem. If you have any problem and you are doing it with by step by step, that you are solving it step by step, then it is called algorithm. So we will use this particular statement, this particular lemma will be used to solve some problem by step process. So it is called Euclid division lemma. Now coming to the next slide, here you will notice that there is an example. If a number is divided by 7, the remainder can be 0 to 6. From 0 to 6 means the remainder can be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Here the dividend is a, the divisor is 7, and q is the quotient plus r remainder. Remainder can be 0 to 6 only. So here what we will be studying today is HCF, highest common factor. This particular lemma, Euclid lemma, can be used to find HCF of any two number. HCF, already you know that HCF is the highest common factor. The alternative term for HCF is GCD, that is greatest common divisor. Greatest common divisor and HCF are used interchangeably. You can use HCF or GCD, both means the same, highest common factor. We can use this particular HCF in many word problems or story problems. So there is an example. Find HCF of two numbers 42 and 30. Here these two numbers are given and I have to find the HCF. These numbers are very small. HCF, to find HCF, we used to check that which number is greater. So the first step is, for the first step, divide the greater number by the smaller number. Here greater number is 42 and smaller is 30. That's why I am dividing the 42 with 30. So by division you can see that 42 is taken as dividend. So greater number is taken as dividend and the smaller number is taken as divisor. Now after dividing, got the remainder as 12. We don't need any quotient. Quotient is just to find the answer. But remainder, we just want to think upon the remainder only. We will perform these divisions until we get the remainder as 0. So how will we get the remainder 0? For this we have to perform divisions continuously. After each division you have to change the divisor as new dividend and remainder as a new divisor, just like in the second step written on the screen. Now after each division, the divisor will become the new dividend and the remainder will become the new divisor. This trick has to be followed for or after any division, after each division. So here comes to the next division. So in this particular division, 30 was the divisor and 12 was the remainder. So in the next division, 30 will become as the dividend. Here dividend is 30. So in the last division, the remainder is 12. So I made it as divisor in this division. So again, performing the division, you got the remainder as 6. Now the remainder is again not a 0. So we will perform the division again, but in the next division, this 12, which is divisor, will become the dividend. This 6, which is remainder, will become the divisor. So performing the next division, the 6 is divisor, the 12 is dividend. Now the remainder becomes, you will notice that remainder becomes 0. It means the procedure will stop here. But how we'll find the HCF between these numbers? So I want to perform these all divisions in one go. Here the HCF is 6 Actually, the SF is the last divisor when the remainder becomes 0. The division in which the remainder becomes 0, at that time the SF will be the last divisor. So last divisor was 6. So SF of these two numbers is 6. Now I am doing this whole question in one go. So first of all, we are given 42 and 30. 42 is greater than 30, that's why 42 is taken as dividend. After performing division, you got the remainder as 12. So after this division, we have to change dividend and divisor. So last divisor, which is 30, will become the dividend now. And this remainder will become the new divisor. Now again performing the division, we got the remainder 6. But again, this 6, which is remainder, will become the divisor, and this 12, this 12, which was the last divisor, will become the dividend. Again, we perform the division. Now there is remainder 0. So the last divisor is 6 here. So SCF of these two numbers will be 6. Now this is the method to find SCF. Now this particular division steps can be written in statement forms. That is the Euclid division lemma. In this particular question, there are three divisions involved, but depends on the numbers given in the question that how many divisions will be involved. It can be 2, it can be 1, it can be 3, it can be 4, it can be many. So depends on the question. But whether the numbers are smaller or greater, but there will be somewhere we'll get the remainder as 0. So we will get the find, we'll able to find the SF of the numbers. Now we can write this division algorithm steps mathematically for each division like by using this formula: dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Here for the first division, you will notice that dividend is 42, divisor is 30, quotient is 1, and remainder is 12. So putting all these value in the first division, so 42 as dividend, 30 as divisor, 1 as quotient, and 12 as remainder. In the second division, you will notice that 30 is dividend, 12 as divisor, 2 as quotient, and 6 as remainder. So second statement will be like this: 30 is equal to 12 into 2 plus 6. Now for the third division, you will notice that 12 is equal to 6 into 2 plus 0. Now this remainder, for the third division, we got the remainder as 0. At that time, the divisor is 6. So SF of these two numbers will be 6.